coming off the Purdue win and playing for a bowl, and the Gophers take the field at TCF Bank Stadium. Under the direction of second-year head coach P.J. Fleck, and there's Pat Fitzgerald bringing out the West Division champs, the Northwestern Wildcats. Is presented by Chili's. On a chilly day in the Twin Cities, the 94th all-time meeting between the Wildcats and the Golden Gophers. We say hello from up top, everybody. Brandon Gunn, Glenn Mason, very happy to be with you. So Northwestern, everybody knows it. They won the West. Pat Fitzgerald, we're not taking our foot off the gas. That's what he said.
Yeah, he doesn't want to hear anything about easing up. Take into account that Northwestern 13-1 in their last 14 Big Ten football games, and they've won 7 straight Big Ten games on the road. They sure don't want to lose that momentum.
And those are some impressive numbers for that side. On the other bench, it's Minnesota and P.J. Fleck going for a bowl game. It's very simple. They have to win one of their last 2 games to do it.
Yeah, and all coaches talk about the importance of going to a bowl game. Yesterday, P.J., the same thing. He said, as young as we are, we really need those extra practices and go into a bowl game. He can't explain how important that is to a recruiting.
Yeah, just in his second season, trying to do that for the Golden Gophers. Now, if you get back to Northwestern and how they have won this season, early on, they were throwing the ball with Clayton Thorsen. Last 4 games, it's been a freshman running it, Isaiah Bowser.
Yeah, where did this guy come from? You know, they were throwing it early because they couldn't run it. They were dead in the water. And then last week, this freshman, he rushes for 165 yards on 31 carries against a tough Iowa team. He's really something special.
Tough Iowa team, you're right, Coach. It's the number 5 defense in the nation that he put up those numbers against. Very, very impressive. And then Minnesota, they've had trouble stopping the run. Last week, though, against Purdue, they flipped the script. They held them to 10 points.
Yeah, big reason. Blake Cashman, the linebacker, a former walk-on from Eden Prairie. I just love this guy. Some guys make plays, some guys don't. This guy always makes plays, and he seems to make the big play at the critical time.
And one of their leaders, no doubt, on that side of the football. Well, we mentioned it's chilly here in the Twin Cities, but the one that really has to battle the elements is down on the field, and that's Elise Miniker.
I didn't even notice it's cold, Brandon. You know, it is cold. It's November in Minneapolis, and I talked to Minnesota quarterback Tanner Morgan about that. Last week was actually the coldest game he had played, and the Kentucky native played at 21 degrees at kick. Today, it's supposed to be a high of 25. When I asked him about it, he goes, Elise, it's Minnesota. We love this weather. He's going to have that hand warmer around his waist. He's also going to have those hand warmers in his pocket as well. Players coming out here to warm up, you would have thought it was Florida out here today. They came out shirtless, in shorts. They always tell me, cold is just a mindset. Well, I can tell you that Pat Fitzgerald told me before the game that he was disrespected when people were asking him before that during the week how they were going to approach this game. He goes, we're not taking our foot off the gas pedal like you guys said. We're going to play physical and energetic. They even brought their own music out here for warm-ups. Another fun fact for you guys about the weather, there's 38 miles of piping underneath this field. It's heated. It keeps it warm. That's so the players can keep their footing and the ground doesn't freeze. When I asked P.J. Fleck about, is it going to keep my feet warm? He said, Elise, it's not that warm.
Yeah. They say it's all in your mind. He must not have a mind, that guy. Wow.
Northwestern kicking to Minnesota on a chilly Saturday in November. Just 2 weeks left in the regular season. And Demetrius Douglas is going to get upended right around the 15 or 16 yard line. So a good job by Northwestern on special teams to get the party started.
Yeah, they put it right in the corner and they had good coverage.
Tyler Johnson, he is the best receiver on this team, and he's been so good this year, knocking on the door for a 1,000-yard season.
Yeah, you know, you talk about the best receiver on this team. I think he's as good as any receiver in the Big Ten.
He has 948 yards, 9 touchdowns, both of those number 1 in the Big Ten Conference. Tanner Morgan, they go to the air on the first play, and he's got it out to the 22-yard line. Seth Green, who's the Wildcat quarterback, with just his 2nd reception of the season.
Yeah, there's a guy that was a quarterback. They moved him to tight end, partly wide receiver. He's really the Wildcat guy, but You know, and it makes him dangerous when he's a Wildcat. He can also throw the ball.
Yeah, he threw a touchdown pass last week, did Seth Green, in that win over Purdue, which really shocked a lot of people. 41-10, Minnesota absolutely manhandled the Boilermakers. Got to the second level and across the 30, first down Minnesota. If you're looking for the Penn State Rutgers game, go to btn.com/gamefighter right now to see where you can find that game in your area. Season. After Zach Anixted left middle of the year with an injury, hands it off. It's Ibrahim lower in the shoulder and going right over Travis Wolick. 5-yard gain.
Well, I'm going to tell you, this game has started out to be very physical. Watch it right here. And a hit like that, it takes two. One guy running hard, one guy trying to tackle.
Listen in. That's some good pop. Bryce Williams, the freshman in the backfield instead of Ibrahim. And early on, Tanner Morgan taking a lot of these play clocks down late. And then hands it to Williams for a short gain, if any. Let's take a look at our auto owners insurance impact players.
Well, you're going to start with Tanner Morgan. The quarterback came in and replaced Zach Anixted. He gives them some mobility. Tyler Johnson, as good as it comes at wide receiver. Patty Fisher, the middle linebacker, really solid versus the run. And Joe Gaziano, you know, the Minnesota coaches say that guy can absolutely ruin a game.
Yeah, Kirk Shiraka said they're going to have to devote an extra guy to him at times just to try to keep him in check today. Last carry for no gain, so 3rd and 5. Morgan escapes and then throws it incomplete. No flag, 4th down, Minnesota will punt.
Yeah, they had him on the run. You know, when you look at the Northwestern defense, they don't have a lot of sacks on this season, but that doesn't mean that they haven't done a good job pressuring the quarterback. There's a missed sack right there, but they stay after him, and the crowd thought there should be pass interference here, but there wasn't.
And Cameron Ruiz is getting just his 2nd start due to all the injuries that Northwestern has had in the secondary. And clean coverage there as the punter Jacob Herbers is on. Fair catch for Riley Lees just inside the 25.
Punt by Herbers.
40-yard punt. 12:04 left in the first quarter, and now Northwestern comes out. We discussed Isaiah Bowser, and boy, has he been good.
Man, for a freshman, and you know, I talked to some of the Northwestern coaches on the field before the game, and they said, you know, the first time he carried the football was like a 3 or 4 yard gain. They all looked at each other and said, we think we found our back.
Boy, did they ever find their back. The issues that they've had at running back early in the season, well documented, but the last 4 games, 3 of them over 100 yards for Bowser. Clayton Thorsen underthrown and a little behind Kyrick McGowan as well. Clayton Thorsen is getting closer and closer to 10,000, just 117 away.
You know, when he's on, he's really something special. You know, we had him earlier in the year, and he at Rutgers, and he had an off day that day.
He really struggled in the last few weeks. It has been more about the ground game than the passing game. And the ground game here with Bowser gets him out across the 30. So it'll be 3rd and 3.
You know, we talked a lot about Isaiah Bowser, but a big part of that running attack, that offensive line has really improved as the year went on, and they really struggled early, but they're finding their groove right at the right time.
Yeah, you're right. Mick McCall told us they're blocking so much better at the point of attack to spring Bowser and company. Looks like he's short. Flynn Nagel, who did not have a catch against Iowa last week, is stop shy. It's going to be 4th and 1.
Yeah, great defense right there. They The Gophers dropped on back to their zone. They saw their crosser coming, and as soon as he went to release the ball, man, they got up there, made a sure tackle. They kept him just a little bit short.
And you know who made the tackle? Your guy, Blake Cashman.
No surprise to me.
So a pair of punts to start the game. Demetrius Douglas slipping through and across the 40-yard line. Punt and punt. That's how we started. We'll see what drive three has in store next. Look at this. Before the game, the Northwestern players coming out shirtless and circle. Who's that? Is that Mick McCall over there?
Offensive coordinator Mick McCall. Are you nuts? He's game ready, baby.
Tell you what, he had his suit pants on and came out for the camaraderie with his players without the shirt on. Off the play action, first down. And who else but Tyler Johnson taking him into Northwestern territory. Now, Minnesota started with much better field position here.
Yeah, you know, you looked at it, they start in the 10-yard line, then they get it back to the, 44. But that slant route, to me, that's the tough play for them to stop. Everybody wants to talk about these run-pass options. They really do a good job of that.
Evidence of it right there, a 14-yard gain. Dropped by Rashad Bateman, one that the freshman normally catches.
Yeah, Tanner Morgan was under pressure there, and he put the ball right on the money, and P.J. Fleck will be saying, come on. I mean, you know what he'll say to him? Bateman, you're too good to drop that ball.
Bateman, a freshman record for Minnesota with 43 receptions, but drops number 44.
Yeah, you talk about big plays. He's got three receptions over 60 yards this year.
Play action throw, and there's Bateman. So now he does have his 44th catch of the season.
Yeah, same play, different formation, but here you go, run pass option. Quarterback fakes the dive or the run to the running back. Linebacker has to come on up and think about stopping that run because they're good running the ball. Boom, slant right behind him.
So 14 yards on the slant to Johnson, now 16 on the slant to Rashad Bateman. So they go to that slant play again, and this time it doesn't work.
Yeah, three times in a row, and there you see it. It's tipped right there by the linebacker, and it gets bounced around, and they're staying after it, and up in the air again. Man.
This is a BTN standout presented by Auto Owners Insurance. So at first it hits Cameron Ruiz. Then off of Bateman, the intended target.
Off his head.
And then watch Patty Fisher flip it up in the air here. And that allows Nate Hall, number 32, to dive in and scoop it before it hits the turf.
How do you practice that?
Ooh, you don't. Second interception of the season for Nate Hall. After a pass that hit five different players. To the 20-yard line goes Isaiah Bowser. Well, turnovers have been the one bugaboo this year for Minnesota. That's their 23rd.
Yeah, you know, you think about that, and P.J. Fleckie talks about the ball. Protecting the ball is paramount in this program, but they've had their problems. Good run by Bowser there again.
4 yards, second six. One more time, Bowser with a full head of steam. And he barrels his way to the 35.
You know, when we talked to Mick McCall and he talked about why that the running attack has gotten better, part of it was Bowser, part of it was the offensive line, but he also said we figured out what he runs well, and that's what we've been working on.
And two good freshmen here today, Bowser and, of course, Muhammad Ibrahim on the other side from Minnesota. swing pass out to Vault. Solomon Vault with 2 yards on the reception. Two for three so far, but just 4 yards. A little more here. First down, slanting inside for the catch and picking it up for Northwestern as we get a look at the Auto Owners Insurance Impact Players.
Well, we just saw the throw by Thorsen. He's the straw that stirs the drink. Flynn Nagel's his go-to guy. Didn't have any catches last week. Carter Coughlin, the defense end, leads the Big Ten in sacks. Jacob Huff, the safety, sure tackle.
And it's running around the left side. A little trick play that time, but it worked well. Berkeley Hallman, he's a guy who hasn't seen much time this year, but he already has a reception in that run for 10 yards.
Yeah, I mentioned a balanced formation. I've seen more teams this year than I can remember utilize this formation, and depending what the defense does, either you take it to the strong side or come back to the weak side.
They put Lees in motion, but it all sets up a Thorsen pass. And it's caught. What an effort. Cameron Green went up to grab it.
Yeah, the super back Cameron Green. And, you know, Minnesota had this well defended, but great concentration. And watch him go up to get the ball right against his chest. And he fights on the way down. Good coverage, but better reception.
Jacob Huff was there, ran into Green, but Green's still able to concentrate and grab it. Bowser, patient, touchdown, Northwestern. His fifth touchdown in the last 4 games, and Northwestern is on the board first.
You know, Bowser has a good feel for this. Watch it right here, and he doesn't rush it. Gets in there, he stays square, which is an important point. If you stay square, you can go right or you can go left. You turn those shoulders, you got a problem.
Joe Rossi, Minnesota's D coordinator, said Bowser is impressive with his patience, and he showed it right there. Waited for the hole to open up. Drew Luckenbaugh, who's been battling an injury and missed last week, kicks it through for the extra point. So the Nate Hall interception sets up the Isaiah Bowser touchdown run for Northwestern. Last week, Northwestern clinched the West. This was the catch of the game, the catch of the season. Bennett Skoranek laying out, and then the defense did its job, forcing the strip of Ivory Kelly Martin. And here's Pat Fitzgerald after the game.
Wisconsin lost. Purdue lost. We won. Yeah!
What a special moment for the 43-year-old Pat Fitzgerald.
Can you imagine? He's 43 years old. This is his 13th year as the head coach of Northwestern.
Wow, hard to believe. Took over when he was 31 with the passing of Randy Walker. And what a job he's done. Miscue there on special teams as the kickoff goes out of bounds.
That is the end of the first quarter.
Nate Hall get 2 interceptions. And Northwestern the only touchdown by Isaiah Bowser. First quarter stats, neither team converted on third down, 0-5.
Yeah, it's a hard-hitting, well-played game. We talked about the open. Both teams have a lot to play for in their mind, and they're playing for it.
You and I have seen a lot of offensive shootouts this year, but we're seeing good defense so far. So after the punt, second quarter starts right near midfield, first and 10. Morgan on the slant. And it's complete to Tyler Johnson as he creeps closer and closer to a 1,000-yard season.
Yeah, Mike Hank, which you'll see the safety, he knows it's coming. He tries to come up. You see it. He slips a little bit. He's going to try to jump that route. The problem is if you jump that route and miss it, it's gone.
14 yards on that reception for the Minneapolis native. Trying to become the fifth Gopher to get to 1,000 yards in a single season. And that's where he stands right now, eight away. Seth Green, the Wildcat quarterback. We saw him catch the ball earlier, and this time he's rushing it for a gain of four.
Yeah, you know, Seth Green was a local kid that grew up here, and then he moved down to Texas. He initially was committed to the University of Oregon. He went to Texas. Something happened. They changed their mind. He decided to come on back here as a quarterback. That didn't work out. Then he was a tight end, then kind of a wide receiver. Now he's a Wildcat. And as a Wildcat, he is a force to be reckoned with.
I asked P.J. Fleck, does he like it? He said, how many touchdowns does he have? I said, eight. He goes, yeah, he likes it. But he was hesitant about that position change at first. Option play. Not a whole lot there as Morgan keeps it to the 30, pickup of one.
Have you ever talked to a quarterback that likes a position change? I've never met one.
But it's worked out okay for this offense.
Mom and dad don't like it. Girlfriends don't like it. But, you know, hey, it is what it is. And, you know, I think that he's really been able, they've done a good job of exploiting or utilizing what he does well. And he can throw the football.
So neither team has converted a third down. Minnesota will try to change that here. Watch the play clock. And they're going to have to take a timeout.
Timeout, Minnesota.
We'll take the break with them. 7-0 Wildcats.
Timeout.
Flynn Nagel trying to get back in this game. Elise Miniker, do you have any update?
And Flynn Nagel is officially out. He will not be going back in the game. You can see him kind of keeping it loose and warm on the sidelines, but he keeps shaking his head no. And in frustration, he actually just threw his mouth guard.
That is a tough loss for the Wildcats, their top target.
Yeah, he had 63 receptions coming in. I mentioned he had zero catches against Iowa, but he is a big loss.
And now Minnesota on offense, third and five. Up the middle, he's going to be a yard short is Ibrahim. So now fourth and one from the 26. You going for it?
You know, this is a tough call for PJ because he's got a great field goal kicker, but I think he'll go for it.
He's going to bring out the Wildcat quarterback, Seth Green, and go for it indeed. Well, Tanner Morgan is also on the field, so you got Green and Morgan, and now Morgan is going to be split out wide left.
Yeah, and he's dangerous here because he will sometimes fake the run and pop it to the tight end.
He did that last week for a touchdown against Purdue. They shift all the bacon to the left side. He'll run it himself, and he's short. It was Nate Hall who has the two interceptions who came in to help make the tackle.
Runner's forward progress was stopped. First and 10, Northwestern. The runner was short to the line of game.
That just took a long time to develop.
Yeah, the thing about it is, you know, that's one of the things on those real short yardages right there. You see, he's going to fake it, and then he's going to go in behind the back, but they had no one taking care of the end off the corner. I think there was a mistake there. I think the back should have blocked the end off the corner. That's my guess.
Yeah, and that end was Nate Hall, and like you said, he came in scot-free. So Minnesota has two trips inside the Northwestern 30 and 0 points to show for it. Thorsen fires a fastball over the middle, and it's complete. 11 yards and a first down to Riley Lees.
Well, that's a good tight pass and puts the ball right on the money and just slides right in there.
Yeah, an awkward slide, but luckily Lees is okay. 2 yards to the 40. Second and 8.
A lot of plays that Northwestern likes to do. They run a zone, but they'll pull the off guard around and try to trap the front side linebacker. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't.
Bowser gets a breather. Solomon Vault joins Thorsen in the backfield, but this is a throw for Clayton Thorsen. And it's complete inside the 30. Another Northwestern first down, and again it goes to Riley Leeds.
Yeah, great pass, great catch, even better protection. I mean, no one's even near him. He can stand there, not threaten at all, put the ball right on the money.
Thorsen, 6 completions to 5 different receivers. Cutting it back up inside. Short gain for Vault.
Yes, Sam Renner got good penetration there, and if it wasn't for the cut by the back, it would have been a tackle for a loss.
Yeah, right up the middle, Cashman kind of disrupted that play from the start, then Jacob Huff made the tackle. Bowser returns to the field, 2nd and 10. But they'll toss it in front to Riley Leeds. So Leeds is seeing a lot of action early.
Everybody runs this jet sweep type of play. Sometimes they hand it off, they'll take it out of the shotgun, they'll pitch it forward, but same principle, trying to outflank you. Now, you know, one of the things here, we talked about, or you talked about a little bit, Northwestern's had a lot of problems with their place kickers staying healthy. So normally you think you don't convert here, you go for a field goal. I think they got to be more of a 4-down mentality.
Yeah, they do have Drew Luckenbaugh back this week. They're still missing Charlie Kubander. But we'll see. 3rd down at 6. Thorsen on the slip, pop to the air and incomplete.
Yeah, that was thrown behind him. Poor pass.
He was once again going for Riley Leeds. So it's either 4th and 6 or a 42-yard field goal.
You can see that's a way behind. That's a poor pass. Very atypical of Clayton Thorsen. No surprise here. With the problems that they've had, injuries with the place kickers, have to go for it. Getting the play from the sideline.
And now stepping back in the shotgun, Chad Hanaoka, the 3rd down back, is out there. Thorsen taken down by Blake Cashman. And Cashman is having a huge day for Minnesota.
You can see why I love that kid, huh? He makes plays all over the field all the time. I don't know if I've seen a linebacker, maybe with the exception of Bush at Michigan, that has been more productive game in and game, week in and week out, than number 36, Blake Cashman.
Flex fired up, a loss of 14. And for Cashman, now over 13 tackles for a loss this year. So the turnover on downs. Tanner Morgan's turn. Another drop, 2nd of the day by Rashad Bateman, and that hit him right in the hands.
Yeah.
How much does the cold weather affect your hands today?
Doesn't affect mine at all. Okay.
If you're Bateman.
Normally it's not that. It's normally, he said, I'm going to try to do something with it. You see his head go to the right. He's thinking about not only catching it, but taking it the distance. You got to catch the ball with your eyes. That's what I used to tell the receivers all the time.
Makes Tanner Morgan 6 of 13 throwing. It does have the 2 interceptions. Ibrahim carries that out to the 43 for a gain of 5.
Yeah, good call there. Get it back to a workable situation, 3rd and medium, where you still think you got to play the pass, and the slant route is the one that's hurt you. But at the same time, if you're Northwestern, you know, sooner or later, They're going to fake the slant and go deep.
Bob and Ibrahim in some pretty good company there with Maroney, Barber, and Shannon Brooks, who is out for the season with the injury. And remember, Ibrahim has missed three games this year himself with injury, so he's done all that in seven games. They go back to the ground. First down, Minnesota across the 50. A tough 8 yards for number 24.
That's why that second down play was so important to get him to that third and that medium where you could go run or pass. And the way they've had trouble protecting the quarterback, I'm not surprised they went with that.
Kirk Shiraka said, this kid is tough. In practice, we have to tell him to gear down. He's going too hard in practice. We want to keep him healthy. Gophers keep it after their first third down conversion of the day. And Morgan, a little low, but it is caught by Tyler Johnson, who was 8 away from 1,000, and he got 1,000 on that reception. So Tyler Johnson is now just the 5th Gopher ever to record a 1,000-yard season. Congratulations.
He's awful good. Only a junior right out of Minneapolis North High School. And was really, he's been a special player ever since, I guess it would have been Jerry Kill that recruited him here. He's really played well.
Back to the ground at Ibrahim. First down. Tyler Johnson now just 125 yards away from the single season record.
Yeah, sliding away for it, got his hands under it.
9 touchdowns, leads the Big Ten. He can do it all. But right now, Minnesota just worried about erasing that goose egg before half. Bateman does catch this one, and he's dropped immediately by Travis Willick, a gain of 7.
Well, what they're doing is they're taking advantage of what I would call the gimme throws. You got a soft corner. You rush, if the wide receiver comes off the ball and stops, and the ball's on time, it's a gimme. You're going to catch it.
They've been effective with those gimme short throws. Second and 3, that pass high. Bateman couldn't grab it. He had him.
Yeah, he had him, but you called it. That pass was, that sailed way high. You can see it coming right out of his hands. He got a good spin, but that's. Yeah.
Yeah, that's one that Morgan has to have.
And, you know, the thing about it, and we talked about, they're so good at the slant. You got to watch out defensively trying to defend it too tight, because if you miss it, it's gone. I'm sure Mike Hank would tell the guy, hey, they can catch those, but make sure you make the tackle. Come back and play another series.
So now third down at 3. First down and more. All the way down, knocking on the door, Muhammad Ibrahim. What a strong carry of 29 yards.
Credit that offensive line, because this Northwestern defensive front is pretty stout.
And they're going quickly into the fumble. Gaziano says Northwestern has it. How costly would this be for Minnesota?
No one's signaling yet.
Second down.
And it will stay with the Gophers. A break.
Oh, man, he never got a handle on it.
Looked like the snap from Weiler was fine. Yeah. Morgan just dropped it.
Very lucky there.
Seth Green is in at the bottom of the screen. It is Ibrahim. And Ibrahim is short. So now third and goal from the 1.
You know, you talk about Northwestern, and they've been really good in the red zone. You think about only 48% of the time as an opponent scored a touchdown. They hold them to field goals, as Hankowitz says. Field goals don't beat you.
Yep, they're right near the top of the Big Ten in that category. Pat Fitzgerald hoping they have another stop, hit him here.
For a young guy, he's a strong kid, and he hits it in downhill.
Got 47 yards on this drive and finished it off with a touchdown run. He also recovered the fumble that Morgan had that kept the drive alive. And now Emmett Carpenter for the equalizer. Carpenter, 251 points, fourth all time at Minnesota. Now he has 252, and we're even at 7 apiece. What's going on with a wrench on the sideline today?
You got me. I don't. You know, one thing about Coach Flank, he's got a billion gimmicks. You know, I don't know. It's normally a paddle or an oar or something, yeah. But now they got to fix the leak, I guess. I don't know what's going on. They just fixed the leak. Yeah. It's a tie ball game.
7-all with 2:18 left. Tyrick McGowan with a chance to return this one. McGowan. Great field position for Northwestern. So a big answer. Now you got two timeouts and still 2:10.
Yeah, you got great field position. So now if you're Mick McCall, you're Pat Fitzgerald, right away you say, hey, we got a lot of time. We got our timeouts left, two of them, and we can go in our two-minute offense. No hurry. Let's just go to work.
Wide open over the middle. Skoranek. Just like that with a 39-yard return, and then that catch by Bennett Skoranek at 23 there in Minnesota territory.
He had a lot of time to throw the football. Skoranek came on a long crosser. Watch him come across the field. And, you know, these things are hard to defend, but typically you want a backstop there to keep him from turning north and south.
Thorsen with a clean pocket and another easy pitch and catch into the red zone. First catch of the game from Ramad Jaukio Bowman.
Well, anytime that you bring pressure, if the opponent picks it up, and that was the case there, it's awful hard for a guy when you're in man coverage to protect the guy.
Jaukio Bowman, it's a homecoming for him. He's from Minneapolis.
I'd look for him to come back to the run here now.
They've got Chad Hanaoka, but it's a keeper for Thorsen, and nobody's home for Minnesota. Touchdown Northwestern. Clayton Thorsen fooled everybody in TCF Bank Stadium.
What a great call by Mick McCall, the offensive coordinator. I was thinking Rudd, so was Minnesota. They faked it to the inside, and there is no one on big number 18. Touchdown. Impressive.
Touchdown coach in 66 seconds. That's all that took. And he missed it. Remember, Drew Luckenbaugh is kicking with an injury. He made the first extra point earlier today. That one wide right. And now Northwestern keeps the lead 13-7 into intermission. Stay tuned. Discover Halftime Report with Mike, Stanley, and Chuck. They're coming up next from Chicago. The West Division champs, they will play in Indianapolis. Northwestern, and they're up 13-7 at halftime over Minnesota. Speaking of Pat Fitzgerald, Elise, what did you learn from him at intermission?
Well, first things first, Brandon, Luckenbaugh is out. We just saw him miss that extra point. So now Jake Collins will take over all kicking duties. Luckenbaugh re-aggravated that injury. Now, in talking about Pat Fitzgerald, he told me he likes the way his team is moving the ball, but he wants to be better on third down. Now, defensively, he's happy with those turnovers, but he said, we decided before the game that we were not going to be beat on that slant route. So that's really going to be a focus of his in this second half. In talking to PJ Fleck, he too said he liked the way that his team is moving the ball, but he says, we need to make more plays on offense and tackle defensively. He said that last possession by Northwestern, that was unacceptable.
Well, you know, I like the comments, you know, by both coaches, and really interesting because each and every week when we've had Minnesota, I've asked the defensive coordinators, boy, how are you going to stop Minnesota's slant route? And they all really don't come up with an answer. Really, Mike Hankwood says, well, you really can't stop it because of the run-pass options, but we're going to make sure we do is it doesn't go for a big play.
Brandon Gaughan, Glenn Mason, Lee Smitaker, and Dean Blandino from Los Angeles. The temperature's really warmed up. It's gone from 24 to 25 degrees.
I saw Coach Fitzgerald. He was had his sunglasses on, and he was talking to some of the coaches, looking where the sun was. I'm sure that there's some places on the field where you don't want to throw the ball because the receivers can't see it or a punt return can't see it.
Can't see with that gun show going on over there on the Northwestern sideline. They're not worried about the temperature. The kickoff goes through the end zone to start the third quarter. Thorsen will start the second half by deferring to Isaiah Bowser. Bowser had 55 yards in the first half. He gets two there.
Yeah, it's some tough sledding in there, running in the inside, but they've had good success by Bowser. Sometimes you got to run for two or three to come back and run for five and six.
This time Thorsen to throw. Over the middle, and it's hauled in for the catch. And the first down just shy of the 50 by Bennett Skoranek.
Yeah, that's a good catch. I thought that was thrown a little bit behind him, and he's come up with some big catches and good protection again. And let's see. Yes, he has just a little bit behind him, and you can see Coney Durr, the number 16, had pretty good coverage on him.
And congratulations to Clayton Thorsen. He just went over 10,000 career passing yards. Only the second ever Northwestern quarterback to do that.
10,000. That's a lot.
Thorsen has been an efficient 11 for 14, 136 yards. Now off his back foot, it's batted down at the line.
How often do you see a safety blitz?
No foul for intentional grounding. Eligible receiver.
He's going to get some pressure coming from a long distance. You see everybody coming there.
Blake Cashman yet again finding his way to Thorsen.
How good is number 36?
Boy, a game changer. Just 1 yard to the 35. Blake Cashman, as you mentioned earlier, from Eden Prairie. He's not the only one. Carter Coughlin, also from Eden Prairie. Quite the duo.
Oh, man. We talked about Blake Cashman quite a bit, but Carter Coughlin, the defensive end, came here as a linebacker, leads the Big Ten in sacks. And, you know, he's not very big. They list him at 245. No way. About 230, but really strong. The motor never stops running.
I like what Joe Rossi said. He said, yeah, he's a few cheeseburgers away from that weight that we list him at. Third down and nine. They're going to go out to Hanaoka. Nothing there. And on cue, it's one of those Eden Prairie boys, Carter Coughlin, with a tackle. So now Northwestern's kind of in no man's land.
Yeah, you don't want to punt it. You don't have a field goal kicker. And you talk about Carter Coughlin. His dad played here. Bob Coughlin played at Minnesota. Mom's from Minnesota. His grandfather was the athletic director here at Minnesota. He had no chance. He was going to Minnesota.
Fourth and eight instead of the punt or the 52-yard field goal. See what Thorsen dials up.
Rushing three.
Long throw, broken up. Hit off the arm of Coney Durr in coverage. And Minnesota will get the football.
Media, timeout.
Mike, good coverage right there. You talked about the ball was underthrown, and Coney Durr, number 16, running step for man coverage. Good job.
Off of play action, Morgan steps up and goes long. Trying to get it to Bateman. There's the flag. That's going to be interference on Cameron Ruiz, and it's going to be the first Northwestern penalty.
Pass interference. Defense, number 18, 15-yard penalty from the previous line of scrimmage. Automatic. First down.
It was just a matter of time until they went to Bateman deep. Talked about he's got three plays over 60 on the year. He can really fly, and he got man the coverage there. And you can see, good call by the official. He grabbed him. It was a poorly thrown ball. He really didn't need to do that. He could have got his head around and probably could have picked it off.
9 minutes left in the third. Back to the normal back. Ibrahim lowers his head, gets to the 35 for a gain of 5.
Yeah, you mentioned he lowered his head. One of the good things that he does, and he does many things, is he really runs with a low center of gravity. He's always got his hands out in front of his toes, that forward lean, which makes him really hard to tackle.
Almost 6 yards per carry this year for the redshirt freshman. Yeah, that low center of gravity is just listed at 5'10", and that may be a little generous. Going back to him. Back-to-back carries, the chains move. This defense trying to catch its breath. Caught right around the 20-yard line by Tyler Johnson, and then he's wrapped up by J.R. Pace.
Yeah, Tyler Johnson is so dangerous because how he runs off the football and makes good, really good pass cuts, and you see it right there that Tanner Morgan put the ball right on the money, and you pick up 8 yards on a first down, you're in the driver's seat.
So second and two. Remember, they got the football off of a turnover and downs, turnover on downs by Northwestern. Looking to cash in. It's going to be close, right around the line to gain. So they're in the red zone, and they're going to say third down, third and very short.
Yeah. We talk about this all the time, but that's what I like, when you can put the quarterback right under center and fall forward.
Instead, they're going Morgan in the shotgun. Nothing fancy, just give it to Ibrahim, but he stopped in the backfield.
Little surprise we didn't see the Wildcat.
Yeah, so now fourth down. You're down six. They're going to go for the field goal.
I'm somewhat surprised.
Thought they'd go for it?
I really am, yeah. I'm surprised they didn't come with the Wildcat on third down, and somewhat surprised right here. If I was...
Instead, it's a 38-yard field goal for number 38, Emmett Carpenter, and he missed it. The most accurate kicker in Minnesota history at over 80% from field goal range.
Media.
And he pushes
timeout.
It right. And Northwestern maintains that 6-point advantage.
Hey, here's why I like Blake Cashman. I keep talking about it. Here's the zone read. His buddy Carter's going to take the dive away. Cashman's got the quarterback on the keep. Now watch him. He's got vision on him. He stays square. Not only does he defend him, he's a thief. He defends him. He takes the ball. He drops it. He picks it up. He's off to the races. The guy's a great player.
Yeah, that was the 40-yard strip and return last week in that win over Purdue. But Minnesota's offense continues to struggle. Four trips inside the Northwestern 30, and they've only scored one time.
Yeah, we talked about Northwestern, how good they are in the red zone, but Man, you got to come away with points.
They haven't been able to do it. Thorsen out to Riley Lees, first down.
I talk about momentum, Brandon, all the time, and, you know, it goes back and forth, and it really felt that the momentum was with Minnesota, except they can't get points on the board. And
as we head to quarter number four from the Twin Cities. Game summary through three quarters. Yardage pretty darn even, everything pretty even.
Pretty even game.
That's exactly what we've seen, with defenses playing strong on both sides. Both teams have 14 first downs, and that guy has no shirt. And Thorsen just throws that one into the ground. Now remember, they're playing on offense without their top target, Flynn Nagel. He went down earlier with the injury.
Yeah, he's their go-to guy, leading receiver. You know, coming in today at 63 receptions coming into this game. Last week he didn't have any receptions, and you know, like they said, people have been scheming to take him away.
So he's had to turn Thorsen to other guys like Skoranek and Ryan Lees and rely a lot on the run game, which gets him out to the 30 here. It's been a game of defense, and the two leaders on defense, Travis Willick and Blake Cashman.
Yeah, both outstanding players, and sounds like I'm the president of the Blake Cashman fan club, and maybe I am, because I've watched the guy play not just this game, but week in and week out, and I just love the guy. Hey, say linebacker, that's what a linebacker looks like.
I'll spearhead the Travis Willick fan club. He's led Minnesota in tackles the last three games, or Northwestern, I should say.
Another big third down.
Third and seven. Thorsen. Got him. J.J. Jefferson off to the races. And he's tripped up. Down around the goal line at the two. 68 yards. Thorsen to Jefferson. First time he's targeted the freshman today.
Yeah, you know, you need some protection. Watch the chip there by the back on number 45, Coughlin, who is really a sack machine, and that's what gave Clayton Thorsen enough time to throw the ball deep. Huge play.
Jordan Howden, who was a track star in high school, had just enough speed to catch him.
Here we come with 12 personnel.
Handoff, Bowser, and he's in again. Second touchdown of the game for the freshman Isaiah Bowser. And a drive that started back at Northwestern's 8-yard line goes 92 yards to the end zone.
Now, you know, on that deep pass, Brandon, I've really got to credit Mick McCall, offensive staff, because they did a great job of chipping Coughlin to give enough time. And no surprise, they're going for 2 points here, buddy.
Yep, because of the missed extra point. They want to get this to 14. Pressure off the edge. Thorsen able to complete it in the back of the end zone to Cam Green. The two-point conversion is good.
Yeah, you mentioned they missed one extra point, but I think the other thing is they really don't have a kicker. Go for two.
Another touchdown for Isaiah Bowser. All the carries that he has gotten, as I said, these are the most rushes by anybody in the nation the last 4 weeks.
Yeah, a freshman out of Sydney, Ohio, and as I said in the open, I said, where did this guy come from? You know, he's a good one.
And right now, in a game that's been dominated by defense, that score feels huge. Nice return, though, by Demetrius Douglas out across the 35.
Here comes the blitz.
But the blitz is kept in check until that last moment. And Patty Fisher takes down Tanner Morgan.
Yeah, that's an uh-oh moment by Tanner Morgan that they'll talk about. You know, there's got to be an alarm clock in the quarterback's mind. And, you know, here comes the blitz, and he needs to put that ball under his arm and run, because they're not going to give up. It was good enough protection. He did fumble the ball. He's lucky that he fell on it.
Yeah, fell right back on top of it. But they did hold that blitz in check, just not long enough. Morgan kept it too long. 3 yard loss, second and 13. Pressure this time, it's stripped. It's stripped and picked up by none other than Joe Gaziano, and that's the guy that they were so worried about coming into this game.
The field is a fumble. Oh, recovered by the defense. First and 10, Northwestern.
Well, Gaziano had a key forced fumble in the fourth quarter against Iowa, and look at this.
Yeah, watch this right here. The young man from Massachusetts, and, you know, they talked about, they said, Gaziano, he said, that guy can ruin a ball game. You know what? I think he just ruined it. Look at that. Donnell Green, that's not very good pass protection there, number 73. But, and Gaziano, you know what? He's mad. You know why?
He wanted the touchdown.
Strip, pick it up. You got to score, baby.
Last week, he stripped the running back, Ivory Kelly Martin, of the Hawkeyes, and this time he gets the QB, Tanner Morgan, of the Gophers.
And they put it in here, this would be the dagger.
Bowser. Good job cutting back inside, down to the 11.
You know what's really interesting, though? It's Mike Hank was the defensive coordinator for Northwestern. You would think when they go up 21-7, he'd kind of play conservative.
Defense.
He starts right off with a blitz.
Northwestern now in prime position at the 11-second four to try to put this game almost out of reach.
And you know we're in four down territory right here. Unbalanced formation.
Once again, that Minnesota run defense strong. Jacob Huff, Blake Cashman there on the stop. No gain, third and four.
Yeah, big play. You got to assume that they're going to be shooting the gaps and coming after it. And you saw Jacob Huff came right there and met the ball carrier before he got to the line of scrimmage.
Last drive, Northwestern was 2 for 2 on third down. They'll try to keep that trend going here.
But you know, like I said, they got problems with field goal kickers, so you think they're going to go for it on fourth down if they don't get it. So I wouldn't be surprised to see if they run it here.
Everybody tight to the line, and they do give it to Bowser. And Bowser is dropped.
Now, the reason I say that is that you give it right here, and if you get it really close, if you get down to fourth and one, you can run it again. If not, now you go ahead and throw the ball.
Now, Luckenbaugh out with the injury. He was the kicker. The punter, Jake Collins, did kick 2 extra points last week, but he missed a field goal of 38 yards. They are going to try a field goal of 29 yards here.
Make it a 3-score game.
Yeah, and it will be Jake Collins. He has not made a field goal since high school, and he's a graduate student.
That's a long time.
But he connects there right down the gap. That's a big one.
Medium.
Jake Collins,
timeout.
His first field goal made in 5 years. And Northwestern scored 10 points in 3 minutes and 18 seconds. 17-point Northwestern lead. They go for Big Ten win number 7. They've only had 7 wins in conference 2 other times in school history. But yeah, thanks to that Jake Collins field goal, that was big. That was makes it a 3-score game.
Yeah, that was absolutely huge. And, you know, I was thinking about them going for it, but that was exactly the right call. You have any confidence in the guy, have a chance. You get that 3-score game, 7:49 to go in the game.
Is the one-stop kicking shop. Kickoffs, field goals, and punts. Demetrius Douglas, he's had a couple of pretty good returns. Escorted out of bounds just shy of the 40. So Minnesota's going to have to try to dig out of a late hole. Tanner Morgan, good throw. Right in between 4 Northwestern defenders.
Yeah, and they're going to have to go fast now because time's a ticking, and there's a penalty here.
Penalty flag that came in late. We've only had 2 penalties in the game.
There's no foul on the play. We're targeting. First down.
So it will remain just 2 penalties in the game.
Yeah, if you're Mike Hankwitz, you're telling your guys, hey, you have to continue to play, but, you know, make them work for it. Time's on our side. Just don't let them get behind you.
Let's see what they were looking at.
Yeah, that's, he tackled with his shoulder, and I'm glad they picked that up. That was not targeting.
Yeah, I think it looked bad just because Johnson kind of cradled in, and then Willett came in last minute. Pretty big hole left side for Abraham.
So now if you're the special team coach for Northwestern, rather than just watch the game, you're getting your kickoff return team ready over there, your hands team, because if Minnesota scores, they're going to go onside.
Yeah, they would need to. Down 24-7. This is their fifth trip inside the Northwestern 30 in this game with only the one score. 2 yards that time for Ibrahim, so he's over 90 today.
Yeah, this guy's not easy to take down, and you see Graziano, look at that. He must be awful strong. One hand, one arm, man.
Some of his teammates call him Godzilla. That's why. Second Nate.
Here comes the blitz.
They pick it up. Morgan on the run, and he completes it to Bateman. Well, Tanner Morgan is 8 of 8 passing in the second half.
Yeah, I tell you, you can see all the flashes of a really good quarterback in Tanner Morgan. He's looking left. Here comes the blitz. He's under duress, but he's got the poise to still find the receiver downfield, Bateman, and put the ball in the money.
Now Morgan for the end zone. It's tipped and incomplete.
Now, here's my big problem with that. It's in the second half of the game, so now it's a gray area. Questionable call. He doesn't play the first half of next week's game.
Yep. And he obviously has had a huge impact here today with 2 interceptions.
Good ball again.
Yeah, Travis Willick jumped just high enough to get a fingertip on there. Otherwise, it could have been a Tyler Johnson score. Travis Willick has been fantastic. All the tackles. And now that pass breakup. Morgan again for the end zone and again incomplete. No flags. Once again, Morgan was looking for his main man, Tyler Johnson, but Pace was able to disrupt it.
Yeah, and he had all the time in the world to throw this ball. And look at that route by Tyler Johnson. Oh, I think he had a hold of his jersey. Yeah, you got away with one there.
Yeah, with that right hand.
J.R. Pace. He must have had the sun in their eyes, that official. He didn't see it.
And then you saw Pace went right to the bench after the play. Might have been dinged up. This time he's able to connect with Tyler Johnson. And Johnson leads the Big Ten with 10 touchdown receptions.
Throwing on the field of a touchdown has been confirmed. Timeout for an injured player in offense.
So the touchdown for Johnson, but then an injured player on the side of Minnesota.
Yeah, I think that's Donnell Green down there.
There's the connection with Johnson. They'd been trying to get there. They got there once, but had a penalty called. And finally able to connect.
Yeah, he's... I keep asking these coaches every week, how do you stop that slant route? And I've not got an answer yet, and for good reason. They don't know how to stop it.
Yeah, they don't have an answer.
Yeah.
It is Donnell Green, you're right, who is the injured party, the left tackle. Extra point good, so it's a 10-point game. Just 4:32 to go as Minnesota tries to make a comeback. It starts with this. Morgan to Johnson. So now, after the Johnson touchdown, will Minnesota go for the onside kick with 4:32 remaining?
Well, Northwestern doesn't have their hands team out there. I would have played it safe and put him out there if I was them.
But Evan Carpenter's going to kick it deep. Dragged out shy of the 25. Might see Bowser again here, his 27th rush of the game. And that's why he's our Duluth trading hardest working player, Isaiah Bowser. The two touchdowns earlier as well.
The first of the half. We have 30-second charge. Timeout.
Minnesota takes a timeout. Here's the look at Bowser's day.
Well, he sure has been a workhorse, and it hasn't been easy going. He's earned every yard he's had to get, and he's got to be able to run zone. He makes nice cuts there, some big plays. For him, a 7-yard run is a big play against this Minnesota defense right now. And if they ever needed a good running tack right now to move the chains, right now to keep the chains moving, keep that clock moving, 4:18 to go, 10-point lead, we still got us a ball game. And punt it, then they made the right decision. If they're able to drive it all the way down, use up a lot of clock, then it didn't work out.
Let's see, back to Bowser. So they'll use another timeout here. And Blake Cashman just got his 19th tackle, a career high for the senior on senior day.
Timeout.
Riley Lease leads them with 4 receptions, but they're going to stay on the ground and not get anywhere near the first down marker. So Minnesota will use that last timeout.
That's their final charge. Timeout of the half. Be a 30-second timeout.
And they'll get the ball with 4:08 to go, down 10. We're not done yet.
And let's remember that Minnesota's pretty dangerous in the kicking game. They've got dangerous returners.
Demetrius Douglas is the one that's back deep here to receive it from Jake Collins. Douglas will take it at the 35. So a 38-yard punt in chilly conditions, and now Tanner Morgan returns to the field. So you do have 4 minutes, but no timeouts left. As you get a look at Tanner Morgan's numbers, it's been a much better second half.
Well, it has, and if we keep talking about that, you're down by, you know, 10 points, so time's still the essence, and you got to move the chains, or you got to catch the ball, get out of bounds, and what you can't afford is a sack. You would expect Northwestern to play coverage, the rushing four.
And they drop one, so 8 in coverage. Long ball for Bateman. Well, there was some hand jostling, but no flag.
Yeah, I think there was hand jostling by both sides. Both guys had their hands on it. When that's the case, I think it's a, you can see they both have their hands on it, and good no call by the official. He's right on the spot, and he still could have caught the ball. Watch it right here.
Yeah, Bateman,
both guys
right.
Looking for the ball, and that's a good pass. Bateman could have caught that.
He had 2 drops on slants earlier. 2nd and 10. Morgan, that's way too high over the head of Johnson.
He's under some pressure right there.
So 3rd and 10. Everything right now, 4 down territory, obviously.
Yeah. And I know what they'd like to do. You know, the element of surprise is so much. I watched the rush last time. Those 4 guys up front, they really kept their lanes. They're not going crazy because they realize the element of surprise. If you give the ball off to one of those runners and he gets a first down, it still stops the clock.
The redshirt freshman Tanner Morgan needs 10 yards. Takes off and runs. Okay, so that gets him out to the 42. That'll bring up 4th and 3.
Good decision by Morgan. Excellent job by Northwestern disguising the coverage. They lined up with one high safety, but they went to two high safeties.
Patty Fisher, J.R. Pace combining for the stop.
Big play.
Will they run it, or will Tanner Morgan be throwing it?
I'd say he throws it.
It sure seems like he's going to. And that will be the case. Northwestern rushes for him. They get home. And the defense, which has been so stout all season long for Pat Fitzgerald, does it again. That time it's Ernest Brown.
You talk about play of the game. You're only rushing four. You're playing coverage. They go with a little twist stunt there. Tackle up and underneath. Good call by Mike Hankwitz, the defensive coordinator. And now you really got some problems if you're Minnesota.
Pat Fitzgerald loves it. Yeah, Minnesota now with no timeouts. They're in a world of hurt.
I think it's time to talk about Murr. Pat Fitzgerald and the Wildcats have won 13 of their last 14 Big Ten games. Last seven Big Ten games on the road. I mean, that is spectacular.
Unbelievable. Yeah, if they hang on here, that you're right. Eight straight Big Ten road victories.
I bet they run it.
I think they're going to run it. I think they're going to eat that clock. Tripped up in the backfield, Solomon Vault goes the wrong direction, back to the 40. Good play by Coney Durr. Win against Purdue. That started the season way back on the 30th of August. Overtime win against Northwestern. All these games pretty close.
Yeah.
The win against Wisconsin.
Well,
and then last week at Iowa.
Well, it's not a one-possession game today, but the number of one-possession games that they won, and think back to last year, they won three overtime games.
Now, that's another amazing stat. They've won five straight overtime games, Coach. Bottom line, if you're in a close game with Northwestern, you might be in trouble.
You remember what I told Fitz? I said, Fitz, if I still coach him, and I was down by seven and I scored at the end of the game, I'm going for two. I am not playing you in overtime.
The largest margin of victory or defeat this year for Northwestern has been 14, as Blake Cashman just picked up his 20th tackle of the day. But unfortunately, it looks like it's going to be a losing effort. Back to the ground, ball upended. So that'll make it fourth down as the clock will continue to roll.
Well, there's only one mistake that any of those running backs could have made here, and that's if they fumbled the ball. You know, it's that guy knows how to play it close to the vest. He's got a little bit more room to breathe this week than he normally does, but it's going to go below 1 minute.
Now Minnesota will have a little bit of time left, but down 10 here after the punt. Stop it. The momentum took Jelani Roberts into the end zone. And this is how the day started.
Hey!
With the shirtless Wildcats.
You can go in your t-shirts. We're going naked on top.
To watch.
Look, we gotta show him again. Look at that guy there, huh?
I love it. With the dress slacks on the bottom.
Yeah. You don't think he'll take some grief for that from the players?
You're welcome.
I will.
So 38 seconds left here for Minnesota. They need one win in these last two to be bowl eligible. Doesn't look like it's going to happen here. It's going to need to be a victory next week against Wisconsin. And you know, Wisconsin coach is a team that they haven't beaten in 14 tries.
Yeah, it's been a long time, and all good things need to come to an end. Maybe it'll come to an end in Camp Randall next weekend.
On the run, underneath. Flag is down.
It is complete.
Hold
holding offense, number 64, 10-yard penalty from the previous line of scrimmage. Replay, second down.
And the hugs are happening on the sideline for yet another victory as he hugs his dad that handles the headsets for him over there. Neat moment.
Hey, he says, I always hug my dad after a win. I said, you should hug your dad after every game, you know? I'm sure he does. Yeah.
Pat Fitzgerald, though, yes, the Big Ten West title, but he's going to take them to 9 bowl games in 13 seasons. Before he got there, they had only gone to 6 bowl games in their program's history.
No one has ever done a better job at Northwestern than Pat Fitzgerald.
So Pat Fitzgerald said his Wildcats would keep the foot on the gas, and they did. They win at TCF Bank Stadium 24-14. And Isaiah Bowser, another big day on the ground with 2 rushing touchdowns. Great second half for Tanner Morgan, but Minnesota, if they want to go bowling, they'll have to do it next week.
Yeah, I think he responded really well after the 2 interceptions, and that guy's got a long, very good future here in Minnesota.
And Pat Fitzgerald is with Elise.
Coach, you told me before the game that you guys were going to come out physical. You were not going to take your foot off the gas, specifically your defense. How would you evaluate their play today?
Well, you know, I thought we, for the most part, played really well defensively. We knew some things we had to stop, and I thought we did a good job of that. But, you know, there's some things that we got to clean up, obviously, as we keep moving forward. But big game for us next week, our rivalry game at home, senior day, a lot on the line.
Isaiah Bowser, the more snaps he gets, the better he gets. What growth have you seen in him over the year?
Yeah, it's been pretty special to see a young guy like that grow up, and just so proud of him. I mean, I think this group will be disappointed with our performance today. That's what's so fun about him. So we'll clean things up on the way home and get ready to go against our rival next week.
Coach, thanks so much for the time.
All right, thanks everybody at BTN, and happy Thanksgiving. Go Cats.
And happy Thanksgiving to you too, Fitz. And that will do it from Minnesota with a final score 24-14. Northwestern wins another one as Minnesota comes up short on senior day. Now let's send you to Penn State and Rutgers. Chris Bosters and Sean O'Hara on the call as we say so long from Minneapolis.